Hello everyone, I'm Simone and welcome to Mama Says. Today we're going to talk about all the newborn essentials that you're definitely going to need. I know it's a case of anxiety, at least for me it was. I didn't know the difference between a sleep suit and a onesie. Everything was so overwhelming when I was to be a first-time mom that I needed to do so much research to help me out. But I've gathered all that research together and here I am to help make your life easier and help you transition into a mom for the first time and make things simple for both baby and mommy. This mama has a lot to say to you. Stay tuned to hear my tips and tricks. First, we're gonna start with our sleep essentials. There's quite a few things that you need for your newborn baby to kind of get cozy, comfy, and sleep well. So let's begin. To start with, I really suggest that you get and invest in one of these baby nests. This one's called the Sleepy Head. It also goes by the name Docker Tot. And in India, it's called the Nestillo, or it's called just a baby nest. But what this does is it kind of gives the baby like a feeling like it's in the womb because of the little bolsters on the side. It really helped with Zephyr, and it's absolutely helping with Serena too. Other than that, we have two kinds of blankets. We do one fleece for when the AC is on, if she's a bit cold, etc. And then we have one nice soft organic muslin. Well, we throw this over when she's in the stroller, maybe if she's in the bouncer, maybe if she's in the room and the AC isn't on, that's when the little muslin one comes in handy. And then the fleece one for the other times. Of course, we need our swaddles. Most importantly, we have the muslin swaddles, which is the big cloth that you can tie around the baby if you're good at it. And if you're not good at it, now there are sleep bags that become kind of swaddles as well. There's a whole bunch of brands that you can use. We'll tag them below. You can check them out. But this is, for instance, an example of a sleep bag that you can use, which mimics a swaddle. Obviously, we need our fitted crib sheets. These are so important, guys, because, you know, I tried buying the regular sheets and it just gets a bit bunchy and messy with a baby. These fit so well on every cot and they kind of like snug in well, giving that nice flat look to your crib, because of course we want aesthetics too, right? Now we're going to talk about clothing essentials for babies. Guys, remember, I know you're really excited when you have a baby, but 0 to 3 months, the baby isn't going to wear all those little fancy clothes of yours. Even if it does, it's going to probably spit up on it in like 10 minutes. I'm joking. Or it's going to possibly, you know, have to change again because it's peed or it's pooped or it needs to be swaddled or it's in a blanket. Clothes are usually covered. My opinion, 0 to 3 months, invest more in the swaddles because that's what's going to really show. Those are the prints that are going to come to life, not the clothes. Now, let me explain to you the difference between a onesie and a sleep suit, because that's something that really confused me in the beginning. So a onesie is this. A onesie could have small sleeves like this, or it could have full sleeves, but it has no legs. So this can be worn with a little skirt, shorts, pants, jeans, leggings, anything of the sort. So this is something that the baby usually wears in the day. A sleep suit, on the other hand, is this. Now, a lot of sleep suits come with integrated hand mitts. This particular one doesn't have them, but all sleep suits have little footies. So they cover the baby's foot, keeping the baby warm and snuggled all night long. So now, considering this one doesn't have the integrated mittens, we would definitely use a pair of mittens for the baby, because babies tend to scratch themselves a lot at birth, especially in the first month. So you gotta keep their hands covered up. It's very important. Say your sleep suit didn't have a footie, or say you are making your baby wear the onesie in the day with nothing else. I would still 100% recommend that you put on a little pair of socks or maybe some booties onto the baby's feet, because that keeps them warm and stops them from getting a little sniffle or a cold. It's extremely important, guys. Socks, mittens, and of course, depending on the weather that your baby is born in, an extremely important thing for the first month is these little hats. These are really important. The head and the feet is where the cold usually gets through from. And so we protect both the head and the feet with our mittens, our hats, and our socks. Other than that, of course, please have fun with all these cutesy little frocks and dresses. Of course, dressing up a girl is a lot more fun than dressing up a boy. But hey, dressing up a boy can be fun too. I did suspenders and little shorts and like bow ties and really cute stuff with Zephyr as well. This is for all those milestone photo shoots and whatnot. But remember, don't spend too much money on 0 to 3. Spend more on maybe 3 to 6 and even more on 6 to 9. Because that's when the baby's sitting up, not really swaddled anymore, and you can actually enjoy the clothes. The next thing we're going to talk about is keeping your baby healthy and happy, which means milk. Now, guys, I can't stress enough on the fact that fed is best. I totally do believe that breast milk is amazing. It's God's gift to, us, right? But at the same time, if you are a mom whose baby isn't latching, please use a breast pump and bottles. It's perfectly fine. If you are a mom who isn't being able to lactate that much, please rid yourself of anxiety. Formula works great. I've given both my kids formula from the first day. Well, I didn't have a choice really, but don't get me wrong. I was breastfeeding the whole time, but I did definitely do a top feed of formula because it was stressing me out to get that much milk. And that's a whole nother story. We'll do that in another episode. But for now, let's start with the feeding essentials. So we're going to start with the breastfeeding pillow. If you can invest in one of these, it really, really makes your life and baby's life easier. The one I use is My Breast Friend. You get a lot of good versions of this pillow even in India now. The baby's able to rest well and get a good grip around you. It gives you good back support. And I feel like the baby's able to latch a lot easier when we have one of these good pillows. So I would definitely ask you to invest in one of those. Another thing that we have is this lovely feeding poncho. We're outside, we're somewhere else, we want to feed our baby. There may not be a nursing room. Half the airports in our country, unfortunately, don't have one. So you just slip this on, put baby in. It's a beautiful, breathable fabric. I'm going to link this below so you know where to get these. Other than that, here comes my best friend. Ta-da! The breast pump. I cannot even stress enough on how important this is. My babies fed more from the bottle, even though it was breast milk, than they did from the breast. That was due to my work pressure, my working hours. I needed to go here, I needed to go there. Even guys, let me tell you something, even in the night, you can sleep. All you gotta do is express your milk, get your pumping schedule on point, and you can feed your baby your breast milk that you can put in the fridge. Let me tell you, the Spectra S1, and no, this is not sponsored, is fantastic. It's got so much power, it gets your milk out like that. It's a double breast pump. I love it. So that's the Spectra. Of course, my amazing Dr. Brown's bottles. These really, really actually do help with colicky babies and every baby in general because it stops the gas production that kind of builds up. These are really good. So I would suggest the 4-ounce bottles for 0 to 3 months. And then sometimes the baby even at 3 months starts moving to higher ounces, like a 4-ounce or a 5-ounce. And this one only holds 4 ounces. So you want to get the bigger bottles. This is an 8-ounce bottle for as the baby progresses. And remember one thing, the nipple that comes on the bottle starts as a number one, which goes from 0 to 3 months. 3 to 6 months, we move to a nipple number two and so on and so forth. So make sure you get all of those as well. So I can't stress enough on the fact that fed is best. If for whatever reason you aren't able to lactate enough or you have your own personal reasons for not wanting to breastfeed, because every mom is different and every mom should do exactly what makes her happy, because guys, a happy mom is a happy baby. So what we use is Aptimal. This formula is really good. It works for us. Please feel free to choose whatever works for you. We definitely suggest keeping a box of formula handy because in case, for whatever reason, you're unable to lactate, please still feed your baby. All doctors will tell you that fed is best and please top up the baby's feed with a formula feed in case, for whatever reason, you aren't able to get enough milk. Another thing, and the most important thing, actually, that we need is burp cloths. Burp cloths, burp cloths, burp cloths. You need them in all shapes and all sizes. So, of course, we need our burp cloths. I can't tell you how important these are and how many of these you're going to need. A lot of people use big muslin squares that they kind of throw over their shoulder. We prefer these. Not only do they look better, they're also easier to handle on the shoulder when you're dealing with a baby versus a big cloth. So definitely, definitely invest in these burp cloths. You need them, you need them, you need them. Okay, so then we have our washcloths. I was so confused. I'm like, what's a washcloth when I started off? Guys, your baby is gonna spit up no matter what you do. Your baby is gonna drool like a little drool bunny all day long. And you need these cloths to consistently, continuously keep wiping their mouth because they're spit up. Bibs, bibs, and more bibs. I mean, you need, I think we need like 5 to 6 bibs a day, seriously, because the baby keeps spitting up, right? On a good day, we need 2 bibs. On a bad day, we need like 6 bibs. Just make sure you get them waterproof, because the ones that aren't waterproof soak in all the liquid after a spit up, and that kind of makes the chest of the baby cold and damp and wet, and that's what leads to a baby falling sick and getting a cold. We definitely don't want that to happen to our newborn, so make sure your bibs are waterproof. Now we're coming down to the toys that you need for a baby. Remember, for 0 to 3 months, the toys are actually very, very limited. A baby usually sees black and white for most part of that period. And so we kind of use toys that have this black and white pattern to it, because what that does is it creates, like, babies see high contrast images at this age, right? So before they start seeing colors, their focus really goes on here. And then the minute they start seeing colors, you kind of flip the little thing around. So these toys are Lamaze. You can get the Baby Einstein ones. They're amazing as well. Of course, we have our little toys. How can you not have a toy that sings, "You Are My Sunshine"? Like, everyone needs a baby toy that sings, "You Are My Sunshine." We actually have a couple of them hanging on our activity gym here. Another very, very important thing is a crinkle book. Babies love sound and touch. By the time they're about 3 months old, they start trying to grab things. Once they start grabbing, again, we've got these high contrast images that go from black and white into the color as they progress with age. An activity gym, in my opinion, is definitely important. At the same time, don't invest in something over expensive or, you know, super fancy, because it's only going to last for 6 months. The minute the baby starts sitting up, the activity gym is of no use. And usually babies start to sit by around 6 months. This is great for tummy time. It's great when you just want to leave your baby lying down, relaxing, chilling. It has its little toys all over that the baby can grab. All the toys have different motions. Some have pull downs, some have squeaks, some have music. You get a variety of stuff out there. So we've also got this little Sophie La Giraffe teether. We have the regular Sophie as well. Sophie has to be a newborn's best friend. Well, definitely a 3-month-old's best friend. So we use the Sophie La Giraffe rattle as well as the regular teether. And yeah, that's it. And there's a variety of stuff out there. So now let's talk about our diapering needs. This is our changing station. You don't have to have a changing table, guys. If you want one, if the space in your house allows you to have one, then great. If not, don't stress about it. It's not a big deal. It's absolutely fine. But the one thing you need to ensure is that you have a couple of these nice waterproof changing mats. What we do with these is we don't only place them on our changing mat, we also carry them with us in our diaper bag, because we don't want to place the baby on some random surface outside, right? We definitely want to use our own changing mats. So get a couple of these for sure. Other than that, of course, we have our water wipes. We use the pure water wipes because, especially with an infant, you don't want anything scented. Again, my opinion, feel free to choose whatever product you like. We use baby Vaseline for our diaper area. We actually prefer it to a lot of the diaper rash creams out there because those are kind of filled with chemicals and whatnot. This is basic, cheap, and it really does the job very well. Of course, if baby does have a rash or anything of the sort, we use Desitin. It works really, really well on diaper rashes, but this is not something we use on a daily basis. Other than that, our toiletries include, we use everything Mastella. This is the body lotion. We've got the face cream. And of course, all our other toiletries, as you've seen already, are Mastella as well. So here is our diaper caddy, and we usually use Pampers Premium Care. We are definitely trying our way around with cloth nappies and diapers as well. We don't really succeed with those when we leave the house, but at home we try and use them as much as we can because we do care about the planet. So of course we need to clip our little ones' nails because their nails grow so fast. It's unbelievable. We usually start with the little scissor clippers because they're a lot more gentle on a newborn, and then we usually move to our regular nail cutter. This is the Tommy Tippy. This is just a usual Mothercare little grooming kit that you get. In the Mothercare kit also comes one of these nice soft hair brushes, which you definitely need. We have the comb somewhere in here as well, but we prefer the brush for when they're that little. So of course, a bottle warmer is an absolute essential. Having said that, if you don't have the budget for a bottle warmer, don't stress, Mama. You can always boil water in one of those little pots and put your bottle in there. It's a lot more cumbersome, but if you can't afford it, don't worry about it. There's always a solution. So I can't stress the importance of a good diaper pail. A baby from 0 to 3 months is pooping and peeing all the time. And for the sake of hygiene and for the sake of smell, you need to kind of cover it all up well. We use the Ubi diaper pail. You can use any good diaper pail that's covered and keeps the smell out of the way and keeps the diapers intact in one spot because you're going to need it that many times in a day. So we use the Skip Hop bathtub. You can use any bathtub that kind of has this infant net because what that does is it keeps the infant inclined. It's easy, it's safe, most importantly, to bathe your infant like this. And what happens is the minute your baby starts sitting, which is usually post 6 months, you can easily snap this net off and get the baby to sit in the tub. So this tub is really good. It's multi-purpose. There's a lot of tubs like this out there. Feel free to make your own choice. So we have our gentle cleansing gel. We use this for hair and body for the baby in the initial few months before we transition into a separate body wash and a separate shampoo. And guys, what is a bath without a little rubber ducky? I'm joking, this isn't an essential, but we love it. And of course, we need our hooded towels. The hooded towels not only look cute, but they also protect the head from catching a chill as soon as the baby walks out of a shower. So, hooded towels, guys. All the newborn essentials that are required. I hope you will share your comments with us below. And guys, don't forget, subscribe to our channel now.